Whether you're adding grass to a landscape, hair to a character, feathers to a bird, or fuzz to a carpet, the ability to apply fibres to a surface is vital for adding realism to any scene. MODO provides a range of hair and fur tools that allow you to both apply and manipulate fur, and also includes a large number of options for controlling those fibres at render time. By applying a fur material to a surface, fibres will be rendered across it. Within the material, you're able to control each fibre's size and shape, and modulate various parameters such as density, frizz, kink, and clumping with a combination of vertex maps and gradient curves. Shading can then be developed like any regular material in MODO, or a dedicated hair shader utilised. And because MODO creates hair and fur as 3D geometry, it reacts to GI in the same way as any other object in your scene. For controlling the direction in which fibres are growing, you can choose one of two methods. For short fur, you can create a vector map and then sculpt the vectors using a range of dedicated hair sculpting tools. For longer, more complex hairstyles, you can use guides. MODO has a range of tools for applying guides to a surface, from the Create Guides tool that grows polygon lines from a surface, to the Sketch Guides tool that allows you to sketch a guide freehand. Guides can then be sculpted in the same way as fur vectors, with tools that allow you to blow, smooth, comb, move, and curl the guide geometry. Hairstyles are complex, multi-layered structures, so in MODO, to help you manage these structures, you can create selection sets. These selection sets can then be isolated, allowing you to focus on the specific guides that you want to shape. With your guides defined, you can then use them to control the direction and shape of the fibres generated by the fur material. Like so many things in MODO, the hair and fur tools are a beautifully integrated part of the application. They fit seamlessly into MODO's painting paradigm, and allow for fibrous materials to be developed in the context of the scene you're creating.